At 11:57 p.m., 3 minutes before midnight on November 3rd, disaster struck in Indonesia. A volcanic plug in the magma conduit of the Laki-Laki cone of the Lewotobi volcano was violently destroyed as building gas and pressure finally fractured overlying rock. As a result, a major eruption followed, sending a plume of ash to an altitude of 40,000 feet and ejecting numerous golf ball to small car-sized fragments of rock high into the air. It would take a sizable amount of time for these boulders and bombs of lava to fall back to the ground, landing as much as 11 kilometers or 6.84 miles from their source. I am sad to say that while many of these thankfully impacted empty fields, some impacted schools, homes, and businesses, causing catastrophic damage and resulting in at least 10 fatalities. One individual stone projectile ejected by the powerful initial blast fell 5 kilometers to the northwest, creating a 15-foot or 4.6 meter wide and 4-foot or 1.21 meter deep circular crater in the ground. Other social media footage being posted shows similar, albeit much smaller, craters dotting specific parts of the landscape. The eruption in question also ignited several fires, one due to indirect panic from the eruption, and many more fires created by the depositing of far-flung lava bombs which burned at least several dozen structures. Additionally, due to heavy lapilli and ashfall which occurred, the sheer mass of material resulted in several roofs partially or fully collapsing. In total, approximately 50 injuries occurred alongside damage to nearly 2,500 structures. It appears the 13.5 square kilometers of forest surrounding the volcano was incinerated by pyroclastic flows, and a chunk of the Laki-Laki cone was destroyed like there was a bite taken out of its center. This is a truly major disaster, and I feel for the people who just experienced this tragedy. And now, there's a chance that further eruptions could occur. Due to this possibility, the alert level of the Laki-Laki cone of the Lewotobi volcano was raised to its highest alert level, that being red, and a 7-kilometer exclusion zone was declared in all directions surrounding its summit. This resulted in the evacuation of approximately 10,000 people. So, why did Lewotobi's largest eruption in recorded history just occur, far surpassing its past largest explosions by at least a full order of magnitude? The answer is that multiple factors which can each amplify the size of a volcanic explosion all combine to create a catastrophic outcome. During the last several weeks, Lewotobi's Laki-Laki cone had been somewhat consistently erupting at a rate of about once every 6 hours, generating a small to medium-sized volcanic eruption each time. However, on October 31st, a completely new and fairly sizable volume of magma intruded underneath the same volcano. It took until midnight on the same day for the gas and abundant volatiles released from this fresh magma to begin moving up the magma conduit. This resulted in a few more explosions on the surface, with the last such event for a time occurring at 5:40 p.m. on November 1st. Meanwhile, underground, the fresh volatiles, gas, and magma ended up breaking a portion of the conduit, causing a collapse and then blockage to occur at 2 kilometers depth. This completely blocked the rise of all igneous materials, causing pressure to keep on building and building. As the hours ticked by, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36 hours and counting, no eruptions occurred, yet the amount of earthquakes being generated continued to escalate, indicating a rapid buildup of pressure. I want to quickly note that the new batch of magma was far more gas-rich than the magma which would have otherwise been expected to erupt in the same time span had a blockage and intrusion not occurred, as much of its gases have been passively vented due to 10.5 months of eruptive activity at the Laki-Laki cone. So, when these two magmas combined, the explosive potential of an imminent eruption further increased. Before an eruption could occur, the pressure would have to become so extreme that it could break through not only the overlying rock blocking the magma conduit, but also a 50-meter thick unit of basaltic andesite lava and ash in place during the last 10.5 months of weaker eruptive activity. And this is why such a severe eruption followed, which I would preliminarily assign a volcanic explosivity index rating of a 3. please stay safe, everyone, and evacuate if the authorities have labeled your area as within the official evacuation zone. Please check this linked website for more information.